encourage them, encourage them. And let them know you gotta stay in the race. You gotta stay in the race. You gotta stay in the race. You gotta stay. You gotta stay. You can't give up. You gotta fight the good fight. Paul said he fought a good fight. Paul said he finished his course, but we got to finish the course for ourselves. We got to finish the crossover, that finish line for ourselves. We got to do it for ourselves. We got to do it. God just said, be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Because sometimes you got to encourage your own self. Sometimes you got to pat yourself on the back. Sometimes you got to tell yourself, job well done. Keep up the pace. Keep on pushing. Pass, push, and don't give up. You got to tell yourself. Sometimes you got to talk to yourself. When you can't even contact nobody on the telephone. When you can't even call a friend, they'll pick up the phone. You can call on Jesus. You can call them 24/7. You can call them early in the morning. You can call them late at night. You can call them in the noonday. You can call them when you're laying up in a hospital bed. You can call on Jesus, my God said, for God so loved the world. He went through, he was beaten, lied on. And when we say people start lying on us, we have a problem. We have an issue. When people mistreat us, we have a problem. And we have an issue. But the Bible says, follow peace with all men. We gotta love those that despitefully use them. The ones that lie on us. Because Jesus, he loves us. He loved us in our mess. He loved us in spite of ourselves. He loved us. And so we gotta have that same kind of love for our sister and our brother. We gotta have a forgiving heart. We have to have a forgiving heart. And sometimes it's hard to forgive people. And sometimes what you say, I'm gonna feed them with a long handle pole. That's wrong. God said, love them and forgive them. You got to love them. And you got to forgive them. In spite of, even if you're not wrong, you still have to ask for forgiveness. You have to ask God for forgiveness, and you got to mean it from your heart. Because I remember when we was children, my mother's here, and when we used to get in trouble, she used to make us say, say you're sorry. You know, Jesus, we didn't mean it, but we said it. Because our mother told us to say it, so we was obedient to our mother. But when you say it, it gotta be for real. You gotta be sincere. It gotta come from the bottom. It gotta come from the bottom of your heart. Because God is the one that leads you and guides you. God is the one that ordered yourself. The Bible says, the steps of a good man. It's ordered by the Lord. And you gotta allow God to order yourself. You don't have to go in places that you've never been before. You don't have to do things that you have never did before. You gotta go outside the four walls and reach the unlovable. Like the pastor said, the unsmellable, the undesirable. You gotta go out there. You gotta go out there every Christmas, every year. We go out there, we feed the homeless. I remember one year, this man, we go on Christmas Day. And we went out there, and the man was all smelly and dirty, and I gave him a bag, and I hugged him. He said, oh, no. I said, this can be washed. This is just honor garment. These clothes decay. These clothes get too small. These clothes wrinkle. You got to iron them. And I was, that's a soul. The Lord said, all souls is mine. A soul that sinners shall surely die. I don't want nobody's blood required at my hands. I want to go out and reach the lost. Because that's our job. He died for us. He loved us. And we have a responsibility to go out there and reach the lost and minister to them and love them. We don't know. We don't know. I don't know what this brother is going through right now. I don't know what he's even thinking as he's sitting in the church. Sometimes we sit in the church. Our body is in the church, but our spirit is somewhere else. The word is just going above our head. It's going in one ear and not the other ear. Because we have problems and we have issues and we can't focus on the word of God. We can't focus on
My God.
He just wants us to know. Uh-huh. We can cast our cares to him. We can give him our problems, our heartaches, our disappointments, because he cares. He's a deliverer. He's a restorer. He's a reviver. He can revive us. And so many people in the church that straddle the fence. They got one foot in and they got the other foot out. And some of them are just lukewarm. God said, I'd rather for you to be hot or cold. And we got to make a choice. And we got to totally, absolutely serve the man that loves us so. Serve the man who died for us. Are we willing to sacrifice some time? Are we willing to go into the highways and the byways and compel them to come? Are we willing to talk to the drug addict, the prostitute, the alcoholic? Are we willing to do that? Yes. And sometimes we may say, because I used to say, that ain't my ministry, I'm not going, I find myself, I go, I get my mother, I get my son, and we just go. You don't have to wait on nobody. Just go. You can make a sandwich, something to drink, and you just go take it. You know the areas where they at.
Amen.
You know where they at. And we have a job. And think about Jesus. Just think about us. And the children of Israel, how they was in bondage, and how they cried out to the Lord, and how they was in the wilderness, and how he took care of them, and how he gave them a cloud of fire, and how he gave them a cloud to keep them cool in the heat of the sun. And I was telling my sister how when I went to Israel, and you know they told me, make sure I bring some sunscreen. I said, I don't need no sunscreen. I'm black. I don't need no sunscreen. I tell you what. You talk about burnt and black. I never seen the blackness. The way I look, I was burnt. You know, we have a job. We have to prepare ourselves. We got to study the word. You just don't go out there. You going out there casting some demons. He going to rip your clothes off.
Come on now.
We got a job to do.
Yeah.
We got to be fasted up, prayed up, and ready to the work of the ministry. God called us. His dying is not in vain.
Amen.
We don't want his dying to be in vain. Not only did he die, he got up so I can get up. He got up so that I can work. He got up so I can lay hands on the sick. He got up so I can cast out demons. He got up. The word of God. We gotta spread the word of God.
Yes.
And he has so much love. And think about it, he's a going up Calvary Mountain. Carrying that old rugged cross on his shoulder. And just think about all the pain and the agony of the world on his shoulder. You know, you may have problems in your family. You may have problems health-wise, finance, and it feel like the burden, it seems like it's so heavy on you, and the load, it gets so heavy, and some people, they get in the bed, they depress, they don't get out the bed. Some people just mope around, they don't do nothing. Some people stop coming to church because they see that God is so good and God is so great and God is so loving and he allowed these things to happen to me. But I've heard and I know for a fact because God said it and the word said it and he told me I would bless the Lord at all times and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. I will bless the Lord because God inhabits the praises of his people. And as you begin to praise him, and you begin to exalt him, and you begin to lift him up, he'll overshadow you. He'll overshadow you with blessings. But you gotta stand still. You gotta see the salvation of the Lord. You gotta be real. You gotta be grounded. You gotta be grounded in the word of God. But all the heaviness of the world on his shoulder, and he clambered up that rugged mountain every step step he made because he loved me. Every step he took because he cared. Every step he took because he was concerned about me. The weight of the world, and I can just imagine the form and the weight. And you know how sometimes you be so weighted, it begin to make you go down and down and down. He had a little help along the way. Just like the pilgrims, 45 of them died. But the Indians, they came and they helped them. We in church, and we're not an island. We can't do it by ourselves. We need help. We need unity, togetherness, oneness. We got to come together as one to achieve our goals, to reach our goals, to make things happen. And he's the weight. I could just imagine the weight just going down. But he got a little help. And he helped Jesus. But think about it. He went from judgment hall to judgment hall to judgment hall. He was beaten. He even had his disciples, apostles, pastors, elders, evangelists, missionaries. Sometimes you may want somebody to pray with you just for an hour. And they won't be able to pray with you just for an hour. They may not even be able to pray with you for just five minutes. You may think your friends, you think you can call on them when you really need them. And sometimes they're not going to be there for you. They're not going to give you an encouraging word. They're not going to say that you can make it, be strong, hang in there. God's going to bless you. He's taking you higher heights and deeper depths. They're not going to tell you that. His disciples, he said, can you just wait? Pray with me just 1 hour. Just 1 hour. He said, just sleep on.
Yes, yes.
Sleep on. Sometimes you got to go through the trenches. And you're going to be all alone. But David said, yeah, do I walk through the valley of death? I will fear no evil. Don't fear no evil. Don't worry about it. Trust in God. Don't lean to your own understanding.
Yes.
But in all the ways, acknowledge God. And let him direct your path.
Yes.
Sometimes people say you're foolish. I can't believe you're going to do that. I can't believe you're going to go out on your own. I can't believe that you're going to go to another state and start a church or do this and do that. But don't lean to your own understanding.
Uh-huh.
Let God lead and God and use you. Just 1 hour. He told him to sleep on. Sometimes you got to cut friends loose. You got to tell them, sleep on. I got to be about my Father's business. I got work to do. I must walk the walk of him that sent me. Why did he say, why am I lying? Not with a stretch across here. I can't do nothing for nobody. I can't do nothing even for myself. Even like the pastor said, bishop, apostle, he said, we were nothing but a bunch of mud. Just nothing but mud. We was formed, our body was formed. We had eyes, we had ears, we had a nose, and we had a mouth. We had hands, and we had feet, but we was just laying there. Just a pile of clay, just laying there. But when God, oh my God, when he breathed, it's a man's nostril. He became a living soul. And even David has to say, what is man? What is he that you're so mindful of him? What is it that you made him a little lower than the angel? Man that you communicate with. Man that you love. Man that you talk with. Man that you walk with. Enoch just walked on up to heaven. Walked on up. And they say a stairway, but the Bible said he just walked on up. Just walk. We want to be caught up. We want to be caught up. We want to be caught up. We want to be ready. We don't have time to get ready. We got to be ready. When he call our name, we got to be ready. We got to be ready. He done went from judgment hall to judgment hall. Done got the kiss of death. Done been denied. Sometimes your friends going to deny you.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes they're going to give you the kiss of death.
Uh-huh.
They would say, I got your back, girl. I got your back. Whatever you need, just call me. This and that. And you know, Tom, oh, baby, I'm really going through. I'm having financial hardship. And you don't even know. They got you on a three-way. Somebody else is listening to your conversation. And then they going to tell somebody else. Just like that. Put all your business out there on the street. He was denied. He was betrayed. But he had a job to do. We have a job to do. He loved us so much. We have a job to do. We can't stop now. We're too close. We used to sing that close, that song. We're too close. We're too close to give up now. We're almost over the finish line. We're too close. We can't give up now. I keep hearing God say, don't give up.
Amen.
Don't give up. Don't give up. We can't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. We're too close. He loved us so. He was pierced. They hung him on the cross. They pierced him in his side. But when they pierced him in his side, it said blood and water. It came out. They put the crown. They marked him. People gonna mark you. If you're supposed to be the king, save yourself. Get down from here. You know how people are. If you're supposed to be the woman of God and you're supposed to be the man of God, why is that going on in your life? Why is that happening? Yes, I'm a woman of God. Yes, I'm a man of God. And yes, it's happening in my life. I'm more than a conqueror. I can do all things of what? They give me strength in myself. And I will. I will make it through. I will. Because I'm more than a conqueror. And that's how people are. They know what to say, how to say it, and when to say it. But you got to stand on the word of God. You got to put on the full armor of God that you may be able to fight the wiles and the trickery of the devil. You got to be prepared for battle at all times. You got to be prepared. He's on the cross. His arms spread wide. And just think about those big old stakes, 9-inch, and they, you know how they do it so that he couldn't lift up, so that he couldn't breathe. So every time, you know, it's painful. It hurts so bad. Think about a 9-inch peg going through your feet and it's crossed like that. And through your hands. And he was so humble. He loved us so. He didn't just love us to pardon our sin. He loved us because he have a better place for us. He prepared a place for us. He said, let not your heart be troubled. Our hearts don't have to be troubled. But we have a better place. We're just pilgrims. We're just traveling through. This is not our land. This is just a tent. And it's covering our soul. Our soul is never going to die. But this body is going to decay. Don't the body decay? Go open up a grave 100 years, 50 years from now. It's going to decay. But our souls, priceless, our souls will never die. And he's on that cross for you and I. But the power, we talked about the blood.
Come on now.
The power in the blood. It said he sweat like great drops of blood. That's just from the sweat. That was so intense. Sometimes we got to be so intense when we pray, because prayer is our secret weapon. We got to know how to use our weapon. Sometimes we complain too much instead of praying. Stop complaining and start praying. And that blood, when it hit the ground, the earth began to shake. Power in the blood. Power in the blood. Healing in the blood. Deliverance in the blood. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood. But the Jesus. And thank God we had two criminals. And then one, you know how some people are. You in a hopeless situation. A hopeless situation. And you still talking smack. in a hopeless situation.
Come on now.
But the other one, he realized sometimes we are in hopeless situations. When you're in a hopeless situation, don't try to figure out. Give it to God. Let him work it out. Let him do it. He was in a hopeless situation. And he looked at Jesus. He said, remember me. Remember me. Just remember me. Because he said, if you remember me, you're going to save me. You're going to deliver me. You're going to set me free. Although I know I'm going to die. But I ain't going to die and go to hell. Hopeless situation. That he had hope in a hopeless situation because hope was in the middle. He can God give us hope. Don't he give us hope? When we don't see no hope, he give us hope.
Yeah.
We have hope for the future because he said, my people that are called by my name, it's something we got to do. That's why America is all messed up. A nation that has forgot about God.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. He said, if we come together, if the saints would pray, but if division is strife and prejudice in the church, it's a divide in the church. The church is fighting amongst one another. Where's the unity? Where's the togetherness and oneness? Denomination against denomination, religion. We got to come together. One God, one faith, one baptism. Just one. We got to come together in unity and oneness. Hopeless situation. And Jesus on that cross dying. Man in a hopeless situation. He said, this day. This day. Not tomorrow, not next week, but this day. I'm going to remember you. This day. Then they will come to break his bones. But Isaiah already said that a bone wasn't going to be broken in his body. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We can be whole. We can be whole in God. We can be whole. We got to just trust him. When we weak, he'll make us strong. He'll do that. He'll give us strength. When we need it, he'll give it to us. He'll give us strength. Sometimes you be like, I don't know how I did this, and I don't know how I did this, and I. You didn't do it.
Right,
you did it on the strength of the power of God. It wasn't your power. It wasn't your strength. It was God's power and God's strength. And not only did he die on the cross because he loved us, not only did he suffer, he bled. And he died for you and I. He said, man did take his life. He gave it.
Yeah.
And we're supposed to give the best of our service to the Lord. We're supposed to give all that we have. We're supposed to give it to him. We're supposed to reverence. And people don't reverence the church anymore. They don't honor the church. They disrespect the house of God. And not only do they disrespect the house of God, they disrespect the man and the woman of God. They don't have no respect. But one thing about it, didn't he die? But he went into the grave.
Mm-mm. Here we go.
The one that was late. But you know, but when the earth shook, I left this part out. When the earth shook, how would I blast it? Hallelujah! The sun refused to shine. Oh, glory be to God. Everything just stood still. Of the graves. The graves. You talk about power? The graves open up. But did anybody get up out of that grave? Nobody got out the grave until Jesus. He got up. He got up. He got up so I can get up.
Yeah.
They got up. And the people, they had a witness because they saw them all in Jerusalem. He did that for you and I. And he let his disciples know, let not your heart be troubled. We don't have to worry. Just like the pilgrims came here from England, we're just pilgrims. We're just traveling through. We got a better home. We got a glorified body that's waiting for us. We got a streets that paved with gold that's waiting for us. We got a long white robe that's waiting for us. We got a crown of glory waiting for us. If we feel what, because the Bible says, none but the righteous shall see God. I have been to so many funerals lately. The individuals have lived a certain lifestyle. And then I don't get it. The man of God stand up in the pulpit and put them in heaven. And they tell us that we're not to judge. But my Bible tells me you're known by the fruit that you bear. If you bear corruptible fruit, then you corrupt. You're in sin. And in hell, where you lift up your eyes, none but the righteous. He loved us, so he gave us a choice. He don't always tell everybody, he don't kick his way in, he don't knock the door down. You gotta open the door, you gotta let him in. A thief will break in. A thief will come through the window and the door. However, because I remember one day, that's why we always have to be prepared to be ready. I know one day somebody was breaking in my house. Do you know I couldn't even stream? And I couldn't even remember how to dial 911. And they was breaking in my house. It was at the window trying to get in. Now, I couldn't remember 911, no for nothing. With black belts, and they got in predicaments, and they forgot everything. They black belt. They forgot everything that they learned. Self defense and everything else went out. Went out the window. And that day, but thank God, God put me in a position where I didn't need to call. Not didn't have a gun or knife or anything like that. But he put me in a position where I pray. I begin to pray. I begin to bind the works of Satan. I let him know I'm God's child. And you will not enter into my space. And by the grace and mercy of God, they decided to leave. Isn't God good? God is good all the time. Won't he protect us? Won't he do it? He'll make a way. He'll take care of us. In your lonely hours, he'll take care of you. God will provide. A lot of times you see people, you would say, I'm too old, I can't do this, or I can't do that. But when I came here and I saw that sister with these 6-inch heels on, okay? I said, we said we can't do this. I always tell them. I'm not judging because I always tell them, I said, look, I'm getting 60, the heels are coming down. I said, the heels, but with God, we can do all things, right? What she can do, I may not can do. What you can do, I may not can do. But what God want me to do, I can do all things through his strength, through his power. I want to do God's will. Not my will, but God's will. I want to stay in his will. So many times we get out of the will of God and we mess up.
Come on now.
But we want to stay in God's will. Saints, just be encouraged. Just be encouraged no matter what. Just be encouraged. Because I'm going to end this. Because that's my son and that's my natural son. Everywhere I go, is I have to take him to the doctor. I'm like, how many years do I have to keep bringing him to the doctor? You keep asking me, is that my natural son? Yes, that's my natural. Yes, I had him. Yes, that's my son. But But sometimes my son don't sleep for 2 and 3 days. So if he don't sleep, that means I don't sleep. And I don't get no rest. Do you think I make it on my own? It's by God's grace and mercy. I never forget.
That's right.
A prophet came in. They didn't know nothing about me, nothing about my situation. All they prayed was, Lord, give her double strength. Not no financial blessing. Not no brand new house. Not no new car. But all I needed at that time was strength. You may need peace. You may need joy. You may need happiness. You may need deliverance. But whatever you need. That's what you need. But at that time, God knew I needed strength. Because you know, when you don't get sleep, I don't care who you are. I don't care how saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized. I don't care how sanctified you are. You don't get no sleep. You don't be grumpy, grouchy, and you're not going to want to be bothered. And then the first thing people going to say, oh, I thought you were saved. Oh, you got a bad day today. Oh, you got an attitude. But they don't know your situation. They don't know what you're going through. They don't know how many days you've been out without sleep. And you still got to cook. You still got to clean. I still babysit. You still got to work. And each day have to keep on functioning. It may take you all day to do what you got to do, but you still have to do it. So whatever your need is, God will provide. God will take care of you. And he just wants you to know, he said, be encouraged. Don't give up. He said to push, to press. Whatever you do, don't give up. Don't give in. Don't throw in the towel. Is there anything too hard?
God.
Is there anything too hard for God to do? Is there anything impossible? He's a healer. And I'm ending it with this. And I thank you for the opportunity to be here. I'm blessed. I'm excited. I feel good. You see that? I'm all excited. But they said I had diabetes. And so I said, oh, Lord. I said, I don't have time to be sick, Lord. I said, I'm not.